What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video, and in this tutorial I'm going to be showing you guys how to create this wheel spin effect inside of After Effects. So the first thing that we want to go ahead and do is go over here, this rectangle tool, and change it to the ellipse tool. You can do that by just holding on to that rectangle tool for a few seconds. It'll pop up this little menu, and then you just want to hold shift and then drag this mask over your wheel here. And let's just change this to none so we can see what we're actually outlining here. So I'm just going to drag these points around the wheel to kind of make it fit perfectly around it like this. So there we go. We got a pretty good outline around this wheel here on our first frame. So now what I'm going to do is right click on the mask and hit track mask, and it'll open up this tracker right here, and you just want to analyze forward, and it'll do a pretty good job tracking the wheel here, as you can see. So what I'm going to do is duplicate this clip, so hit Control D, and on this bottom layer we can just go ahead and delete that mask. And then on the top layer, I'm going to pull up that mask. Hitting M on the keyboard brings up the mask, and let's just bring that to add. Now we want to go to the effects and presets and search up twirl. Let's drag that onto our clip, and let's make the twirl radius 100. And when we mess with the angle here, you can see that the wheel starts to spin, but obviously we don't want it to be like this spinning around, because that just looks awful. So we want to mess with the twirl center here, and you can see the point move around on the screen right there. So you can just drag this to the center of the wheel here, and it's going to change in the clip. So what you want to do is hit a keyframe at the start of that twirl center and just go to the end and bring that to the center of that wheel once again. And it might mess up a little bit towards the middle of the clip, so let's mess with that. Now that we have that fixed, what we can do is go up to the angle here and set a keyframe at the very start at 0, and then let's just go to the end of our clip here, and let's just drag that to like a pretty high value here. Let's just play that back, see what it looks like. So there we go, the wheel is now spinning. But what I'm going to do is hit U on my keyboard to bring up these keyframes here, and let's just select the angle keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them, and then go into the graph editor, and let's just make a graph that looks something like this here, so it just speeds up super fast like that. So now what we're going to go ahead and do is add some motion blur. Let's go back to the effects and presets and search up radial blur, and let's just drag on the CC radial blur right here, and let's change the amount to like 7. And then once again, you can see that the center isn't like perfect, it's not actually on the wheel, so we just want to go to the center value, or we can drag this point here, move that to the center of that wheel there, and let's just keyframe this once again. So to the start of the timeline, just mark the keyframe, go to the end, and just fix that so it's in the center of the wheel right there. Now we don't want the motion blur to be applied the whole time, so I'm just going to have the motion blur start at 0. So I'm going to bring that amount back down to 0. And then at the very end, we can crank that back up to 7. And if you want a stronger motion blur amount, you can obviously crank that up to like 12 or 15. So now you get a lot more motion blur when the wheel starts to spin. So kind of mess with that, kind of see what looks good in your footage. All right, so there you go. That is pretty much the finished effect. You can add like a saber outline if you want. I'm just going to duplicate that clip with a mask and just delete those effects and add the saber effect onto that clip. And I'm just going to go through this super fast. So you can just follow along while I do this, but I basically do the same thing right here as I did in my tutorial where I do the outline effect, the saber outline effect. So if you want a more in-depth tutorial on how I do this, then I should have watched that video. Basically, I'm just going to change this end size to 0, and let's just set a keyframe for the mask evolution at the start, and then go to the end and just drag that maybe around here. And then once again, we just want to go ahead and make a graph that is similar to what we did for the wheel. I'm going to change this preset to neon and change that color to match the car here. And then I'm just gonna keyframe the start size here, slowly fade in to 100%. So there we go. That is how we create this wheel spin effect. It's honestly a pretty simple effect. It only requires a few effects and just some simple masking. So yeah, go ahead and use this in your next edit and have fun messing around with it. And if you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to drop a like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Peace out.